A very good morning to all of you, my dear students. Welcome back to the class and welcome back to the YouTube channel. Let's learn together again. So we are going to discuss the chapter 8 of Social and Political Life of Grade 6. And the name of the chapter, you can see Rural Livelihoods. So rural, that means village side, and rural areas that is not connected with the cities. They are separated. But people used to go and come from the cities. The people who are living in the villages, they have the connection. So we are going to learn about how they really earn their livelihood. What are livelihoods? Actually, livelihoods are different ways in which people earn their living. That is known as livelihood over here. So these are different type of ways from which people earn their living, from which people earn money to spend, to use. So this is known as livelihood, where people use different ways to earn their living. We all know that everyone need these things, such as we know that everyone need food, everyone need clothes, everyone need house. So food, clothes, and shelter. Shelter means that is house. Everyone has these basic needs. They require these basic needs. And in order to provide, in order to achieve these basic needs and other necessities of life, a person does some kind of work. Everyone. If your father, even someone, mother also is working, doing some kind of work for earning this livelihood, to get this food, clothes, and house. Now, the basic things have included many things in our life, such as having a mobile phone now has become the basic thing also. But really, we can live our life without a mobile. We were living our life without a mobile, but we never lived our life without this food, clothes, and house. And it was quite struggling when we were not having this. So everyone tried to earn this life, earn their livelihood. So this is called profession or occupation. What a person is doing to earn their livelihood, that is known as his or her profession or occupation. One may be a farmer, one may be a teacher like me, one be a doctor, maybe like your father or your mother, maybe like an engineer, one may be an engineer, or one may be a lawyer also. So that is known as the profession, my dear students. Will everyone write me in the chat box? So your father may be a teacher, but no one, a few of them said also that their father or mother is a government teacher, as a teacher also, doctor also, engineer also, lawyer, maybe someone father is a, or mother is a lawyer also. So in this chapter, we will look at livelihoods in rural areas or villages. We will see to it that what are the people doing in the villages to earn their livelihood. These are the profession that just we have discussed. These are the profession, teacher, doctor, engineer, or lawyer are available everywhere. So let us see. We are going to discuss about the village Sherpur. Let's visit a village called Sherpur in Bihar. This village is located near a river, and that river, as a river is nearby, fishing is an important livelihood. So the first thing that we have come to know about these village people, that fishing is important for the people of this village. That is, they are doing fishing for earning their livelihood because they have a river nearby. People belonging to the fishermen community known as Malla. Those who belong to the fishermen community, yani Machware, Machwara is also known as, and Malla is also known as, their community is also known as by the name of Malla. They take up fishing as an occupation. So fishing is their occupation. They used to catch fish from the river, and then they used to sell it in the market, and whatever amount they used to get after selling the fishes, they used to purchase the needs of their life, the things which is needed in their life. Most of the people are farmers of this village, most of the people, because many people are also doing fishing, but most of the people are farmers who cultivate land and grow crops. there are non-farm occupations also. So there are many activities which are non-farm activities also, means they are not directly connected with the land and growing crops, but they are doing something such as making baskets from bamboo, making potteries, making pots, making bricks, making or driving a bullock cart, you know, in the market to carry the loads from one place to another. So people are involved in these activities also, which are non-farm, you know, which are not connected to growing the crops. That's why it has been said that they are non-farm activities, such as making baskets from bamboo, making potteries, making bricks, or driving a bullock cart. Even people are involved, most of the people are involved in cultivating land and growing the crops. And they not only grow crops for them, but also they grow crops for us also. There are many people who are blacksmith also, लोहार जिसको कहते हैं, दे आर गोल्ड स्मिथ, सुनार, दे आर कारपेंटर्स, नर्सेस, मिडवाइव्स, टीचर्स, वॉशरमैन, इवन वीवर्स, दोज हू वीव, बार्बर्स, दोज हू कट आर हेयर्स, डोमेस्टिक सर्वेंट्स ऑल्सो, बहुत सारे ऐसे भी हैं जो घरों में काम करते हैं. सो मेनी पीपल आर लिविंग देयर एज ए डोमेस्टिक सर्वेंट, एंड डोमेस्टिक सर्वेंट आर अवेलेबल बोथ इन सिटीज एज वेल एज रूरल एरियाज एज वेल एज अर्बन एरियाज हु परफॉर्म वेरियस नॉन फार्मिंग एक्टिविटीज. सो दीज एक्टिविटीज आर नॉट रिलेटेड टू ग्रोइंग क्रॉप्स, नॉट रिलेटेड टू द फील्ड वेयर द फार्मर्स आर वर्किंग. दैट्स व्हाई दीज एक्टिविटीज आर नोन एज नॉन फार्मिंग एक्टिविटीज, सच एज because they are not connected to any farm or not connected to growing crops such as blacksmith, goldsmith, carpenter, nurse, teachers, washermen, midwives, weavers, barbers, domestic servants. They perform various you can say many non-farming activities. These are the activities which are also quite important and easy to learn on their livelihood. But I am saying easy because I am not doing this work. But if I will do that work, if I will make bricks, if I will drive a bullock cart, then I will learn that how hard, how tough are all these work. All these work are very tough. But I am not doing that, so I am saying that it is easy. But it is not so easy, my dear. Even catching a fish is not so easy. You don't think that it's quite easy to catch fishes also. It will make you run. So let us move to the next part of the chapter, my dear students. And the next part of the chapter is showing various types of rural livelihoods. People are doing various kind of activities. Let me zoom it so that we can watch it in a good way. Yeah, you can see, my dear students, over here in the first image that you can see that people are doing fishing. They are trying to catch fish, you know, with their nets. And in the second, you can say there is a farmer. You can see there is a farmer who is trying to cultivate the land. And the third image, you can see this one, someone is selling the fruits and vegetables. And you can see even someone is repairing the bicycle. And you can see someone is just working in the field also. Someone is, you can see over here, that is the work. That is also a different work over here. People are making houses, and even women are carrying, doing work. And you can see here people doing pottery work. Someone is selling in the shop, and even someone is gardening and growing. People and children are playing in the field also. You can see over here. So these are the work, my dear students. Barber, I haven't seen over here. The feature, it is not there. But Manson, you can see the people is the who used to lay down the bricks and build the buildings. They are known as Manson also. So you can see in this picture a lot of various of works have been shown over here, that the people in the rural areas, they are doing, they are performing. Village Sherpur, there is a, you can see there is an image showing the village Sherpur, and everyone is busy, you know, you can see. So there are shopkeepers, there are traders, there are grain merchants, those used to say sell the grain, you know. Grain means yani ke anaj ko jo bechte hain, uske bhi merchant, uske bhi traders hote hain. So there are shopkeepers, traders, and grain merchants. And at the village square, there are a variety of shops. And we have seen the shopkeeper also. We find a few shops selling tea, selling snacks, and a chai biscuit wale dukan, and other eatables, and someone is selling cake, someone is selling something, eatable things, and khane peene ke cheez bechne wale bhi. Bahut sare shops aapko milenge. You will find a lot of shops in the village square, and in the morning and evening, they prepare samosas, my God, pakoras and jalebis. Really, I will eat all this today because I'm just liking. When I hear the name, yes, it is reminding me and asking me to eat all these, you know, samosas, pakoras, jalebis. But let me tell you, they might be unhealthy also. You know, be very careful. Purchase it from the good shop. They also sell curd, dahi bhi beste hai, and even sweet meats, yani mithai. There are few clothes shops also, tailor shop also, some fertilizers, you know, and some seed shops. So many of them are selling the fertilizer. Fertilizer, these are the materials which are used while growing the crops also. People, farmer used to use this fertilizer, and even the farmers come to buy the seed also from the shops. There are two shops which sell items of daily use like soaps, oil, sugar, spices, and ye hum log ko daily zarurat padti hai. So there are shops who sell all these things also. There might be shops also who used to sell bread also, bread, butter, milk, and all these are the requirements of daily life. A few barber shops and grocery shops are also located in a corner of the square. So few barber shops also there, free few grocery shops are also there, and those used to sell groceries. Two cycle repair shops also are there, those who are busy throughout the day, because many of the people, most of the people of the village, they use cycle, and that's why they remain healthy also throughout their life, because cycling is also a type of exercise. So cycle repairing shops are also available, and they are quite busy because most of the people are having cycle. So the cycle gets needs repairing also time and time again. Now let us see few more. Rice and wheat are the main crops that the people of village Sherpur, they used to grow rice and wheat. That is the main crop of that village. It must be that the soil of the village is very supportive to grow rice and wheat. That's why people are growing rice and wheat. Villagers also grow some pulses, that is dal bolte hain, dal, bahut sare dal bhi grow karte hain. So villagers are also growing pulses and oil seeds for self consumption, not for selling. They are growing pulses and oil seeds to get some oil, mustard oil, like mustard oil. They can get mustard oil by the oil seed by growing the mustard in their field. So villagers are growing pulses and oil seeds, not for selling, for using at their home. That is known as self-consumption, for using it at their home only. They grow sugar cane on large scale, yani ganna. They used to grow it on large scale. The sugar canes are carried to sugar mill located 2 miles away, means around 3 kilometers away. You know, 1 mile equal to 1 mile equal to 1.6 kilometer approximately. So the sugar cane are carried to sugar mill, you know, where they used to make sugar from the sugar cane. So that sugar cane mill, that sugar mill is 2 miles away from the village, almost 3 kilometer. There is also a dairy in the village, those who used to supply milk to the villagers. Those farmers who keep buffaloes and cows, they sell their milk here in the dairy. So many farmers are also there who used to grow what? Who used to keep buffaloes and cows and sell the milk of those animals. They are paid weekly or monthly. You know, those farmers, they get the payment from the dairy where they are selling the milk. They used to get the payment, not daily, but weekly, or they can get it monthly also. It is run by a cooperative society. Now, that is quite important to know over here, my dear students. They are having a society there, cooperative society. So there are dozens of buffaloes and cows in the village. So they are selling, they are having cooperative society which will look into the dispute or any problem of the villagers, that cooperative society. So there are dozens of buffaloes and cows in the village because people are selling the milk, using them, domesticating those animals at their home and selling their milk, even using their milk for their personal use also. Milk is also a good source of income for the villagers. So apart from growing crops in the field, the selling milk is also a good source of income. Some families also keep goats, and a goat also used to give milk, and even you can eat the meat also. So goats, they are grazed by children in the pastures and the fallows. Pastures and the fallows are the open field, and इसको क्या बोलते हैं, ओपन फील्ड को बोलते हैं, वेयर द ग्रीन ग्रासेस आर अवेलेबल. सो मेनी चिल्ड्रन दे यूज टू टेक दोज गोट्स एंड शीप्स है ना टू दोज प्लेसेस फॉर व्हाट, फॉर ग्रेजिंग, सो दैट दे दोज एनिमल्स कैन ईट दोज ग्रासेस फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट. एंड अगेन यू कैन सी दोज एनिमल्स प्रोवाइड मिल्क एंड मटन बोथ है ना. People are getting milk and people are getting mutton also from those animals. A local fair that is known as haat is also held twice a week in every village. You will listen to this, that aaj haat lagne wala hai, kal haat lagne wala. It means what? A local fair where all the people of the villages will take part, will participate, and they will sell all their articles, whatever they are having, they will go there and start selling, and all the villagers who require those things, they will come and purchase, they will start buying. So buying and selling items like vegetables and vegetables, earthen pots, mutton, fish, and these are the things which will be available in bulk, in large quantity in that particular fair known as haat. Also the village is surrounded by mango orchards and bamboo forests. The village Sherpur is surrounded by mango orchards. Let me show you mango orchards, because many of you might be thinking of asking me this question. So before you ask, I will let you know, I will show you that mango orchards, okay, in the image. Let me show you in the image mango orchards. You can see, है ना, यानी कि आम के यहाँ बहुत सारे पेड़ एक साथ होते हैं. That is known as mango orchards. A lot of trees in the symbol, in the single line they are having, है ना. This is known as mango orchards. You can show. Let me zoom it. You can see this picture. Mango orchard. यानी आम के बहुत सारे पेड़ एक साथ हैं. And even bamboo forest, if you want to see, then we can go through in the Google. It is available for us. Bamboo forest search. Yeah, you can see bamboo forest over here, my dear student. And it is quite really amazing. That scenery is very good. आप जाएंगे, आपको बहुत मजा आएगा. यू विल स्टार्ट टेकिंग सेल्फी एंड सेल्फी एंड सेल्फी, मेनी सेल्फीज, हंड्रेड्स ऑफ थाउजेंड्स ऑफ सेल्फीज एट एवरी प्लेस, बिकॉज़ यू विल लाइक सो मच. बट टेकिंग सेल्फी माइट बी डेंजरस ऑल्सो, माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, है ना. सो बी वेरी केयरफुल वाइल टेकिंग सेल्फीज ऑल्सो. यू नो दिस इज द बैम्बू फॉरेस्ट. ओके, सो लेट अस मूव अहेड. सो अगेन यू कैन सी, माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, did you know there are questions over here? Fishing is an important means of livelihood, but we will discuss this, all this, in our next class, my dear students, because the class is going to end very soon. We have just 1 minute left. Okay, so that's all. Stay at home and stay safe, my dear students. Bye bye, take care.